سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله
اللهم توفنا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين اللهم أحينا مسلمين وأمتنا مسلمين اللهم بارك لنا في الموت وفيما بعد الموت اللهم ربنا أعطِ أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها أما بعد محمد ابن المنكدر very famous from amongst the tabi'in محمد ابن المنكدر عليه رحمة محمد ابن المنكدر عليه رحمة began to cry as death approached why the need to weep someone asked I am not weeping as a result of any sin that I may have committed. From my knowledge, I have not committed a single sin throughout my life. Such people existed in the Ummah, subhanAllah. I weep on that matter which I may have deemed trivial, whereas it is something grave in the eyes of Allah. I weep on that matter which I may have deemed trivial and insignificant and small, whereas it is something grave, serious in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He then recited the following Quranic verse. وَبَدَى لَهُمْ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَبَدَى لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ ما لم يكونوا يحتسبون وبدا لهم من الله ما لم يكونوا يحتسبون and what they never thought of shall become plain and ظاهر to them from Allah and he then said I fear for something which I did not envisage to happen when we read the Holy Quran We come across this verse, must also contemplate that sometimes in life we think something is small, insignificant, trivial, but it is grave in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a nasihat and lesson we have learned from Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir alayhi rahmah, the verse of the Quran, وَبَدَى لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ ما لم يكونوا يحتسبون and what they never thought of and considered small and insignificant shall become plain to them from Allah. Abu Shuaib Salih ibn Ziyad alayhi rahma. Amr ibn Ubaid Rahimahullah says, Abu Shu'aib Salih ibn Ziyad, Rahimahullah, fell ill. So I visited him and found him experiencing the pangs of death, Sakaratul Maut. He said to me, Shall I impart to you good news? Shall I impart to you good news? I am seeing here a stranger with an odd appearance. When I asked him who he was, he said, I am the angel of death. I said to him, treat me gently. So he said, to treat you gently is what I have been ordered to do. I have been ordered to do that, to treat you gently. Subhanallah. May Allah make us amongst those whom the angel of death will also treat gently. For after all, dying is part of life. Muhammad ibn Aslam, At-Tusi, alayhi rahma. Muhammad ibn al-Qasim alayhi rahma says, 4 days prior to his death, my sheikh, my mentor, Muhammad ibn Aslam al-Tusi alayhi rahma said, he said, come, I will impart good news to you about how Allah favored your companion, that is myself, in that my death is near, and I do not even possess one dirham which I would have to account for. Now, lock the doors of the house. Lock the doors of the house, the sheikh is telling his murid, and do not grant permission to anyone to come near me until I die. And know that I do not possess anything that could be distributed as inheritance other than this sheet, that sackcloth, the water pot for wudu, and my books. Also listen, this bag contains 30 dirhams. They are not mine, but belong to my son. One of his relatives gave them to him. And what can be more pure for me than that? Especially with the statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, anta wa maluka liyabik, you and your wealth belong to your father. This wealth, on the basis of this hadith, is therefore pure for me. Use from that wealth to purchase enough shroud to cover my satr, and not any more. In other words, purchase a lungi only and incorporate this sackcloth and sheet into the shroud alongside it. Hence it will make up the 3 cloths that make up the shroud, the lungi, sheet and sackcloth. Wrap my body in them. And as for this water pot for wudu, give it as sadaqah to a poor person who performs his salat. He passed away 4 days after relating all of this. The brother of Hassan ibn Hay alayhi rahma. Hassan ibn Hay alayhi rahma says, the night my brother Ali passed away, he called for water to be brought to him. I was on the brink of starting salat, so I took it to him after the salam. But when I took the water to him, he said, I have already drank it. I have already drank it. How did you manage that when there is none other than me and you in the house? He's asking his brother Ali. His brother said, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam brought water and helped me. He helped me drink it. And he said, you and your brother are amongst those whom Allah has favored. You and your brother are amongst those whom Allah has favored, which is an ishara, an indication towards the verse found in the ninth part of Surah An-Nisa. It's an indication towards that. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ, and whoever obeys Allah and the Rasul, فَأُولَٰئِكَ, whoever obeys Allah and the Rasul, they have the quality of ita'at, obedience to Allah and His Rasul. And those are the people, مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ, who will be with those whom Allah has bestowed His favors upon. And who are those people that He will be with them? مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ, وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا, and what a beautiful company they are. And in that way he passed away. How fortunate he was. How fortunate he was. May Allah grant us all beautiful deaths. Abu Yaqub An-Nahr Jawri alayhi rahma. Abu Hassan al-Muzani says, when Abu Yaqub An-Nahr Jawri alayhi rahma was in his death throes, I dictated the declaration of faith to him, La ilaha illallah. But he looked at me laughing. Are you dictating the declaration of faith, the kalima, to me? By that one who will never die, only the veil of his greatness and honor separate us. Only the veil of his greatness and honor separate us and nothing else. Having said this, his soul and his ruh departed his body. Subhanallah. Muzani, holding his beard, used to say, a hairdresser like me, dictating the declaration of faith to a saint of Allah. A hairdresser like me, dictating the shahada to a saint and a wali of Allah. What a shameful thing. What a shameful thing. Muzani, Al-Muzani used to weep each time he remembered this incident. Abu Ali Rodbari's sister, Fatima, she says, at the time of his death, my brother's head was in my lap, the lap of a brother, the head of a brother in the lap of his sister. He opened his eyes and said to me, the doors of the heavens have been opened. Jannah has been adorned and a caller is calling out. We will take you to such a place that your heart has not even imagined it. Abu Ali, though you did not long for such a high rank, we have elevated you to that level where even the houris of Jannah are desirous to see you and are dotting and are doting on you. Yet my heart says, I swear by you, I will not gaze at anyone other than you, O Allah. After having spent the whole life in wait, it cannot happen that I lose everything for a bribe. Despite all of that, he's telling his sister that the doors of Jannah have been opened. What a beautiful that. The doors of Jannah have been opened. The Alam-e-Akhirah has been opened unto him. Jannah has been adorned and this caller is calling out. We will take you to such a place that your heart has not even imagined it. Abu Ali, though you did not long for such a high rank, we have elevated you to that level where even the houris of Jannah want to see you. They are desirous to see you and they are doting on you. But look at his answer, subhanallah. Not Jannah, not the beauty of Jannah, not the houris. He says, yet despite all of that, my heart says, I swear by you, O Allah, I will not gaze at anyone other than you. After having spent the whole life in wait, it cannot happen that I lose everything for a bribe. No. He then uttered two poems, translation of which is, by your truth, never have I raised my gaze to look at anyone with love besides you. And this is al-hubbul hakiki, real true love. Sometimes love in this world is kind of bittersweet. Sometimes it's sweet, but sometimes it's also bitter too. Difficulties go with that love. Sometimes heartaches. But with Allah's love, there is nothing like bittersweet. It's only sweet. The bitterness will come. Yes, a type of bitterness too will come with trials and tests and some difficulties along the path. But no heartaches. No disappointments. By your truth, he says, after seeing this, his head is in the lap of his sister. The Jannah has been opened for him. Abu Ali, caller is calling out, even the houris are desirous. He mentions that, oh Allah, I will not look at anyone else besides you. After waiting my whole life, I won't take a bribe. And then he uttered two poems. By your truth, never have I raised my gaze to look at anyone with love besides you. You are Al-Mahbubul Haqiqi. You are making me restless through my ill eyes and these cheeks. You are making me restless through my ill eyes and these cheeks, which have turned red out of bashfulness. They have turned red out of bashfulness. What love, what muhabbat. He used to say, Abu Ali used to say, I do not want Jannah and its pleasures. I don't want Jannah and its pleasures. I want you. I want you, Ya Rabb. I want you. I desire yourself. And this is what is meant when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that when we pray about love and about matters of the heart, he taught us to pray, Allahumma ij'al hubbak wa la make your love. Allahumma ij'al hubbak wa la make your love. Ahabba ilayya, more beloved to me, min nafsi, than me and myself and my nafs. Wa ahli, and then make it more beloved to me than my wife and family. Wa min al-ma'il barid, and more beloved to me than cold water. This is the reality of such a love. This is love manifest, a love of Allah, which is more beloved than anyone else, anything else, more beloved than one's own self, one's family and wife, and even cold water, because the Arabs, they enjoyed cold water. That is one drink that nobody can become fed up of. A person might can become fed up of Coca-Cola, juice, sharbat, faluda, what it may be, but not cold water. It's a drink that one never tires of. More beloved than cold water, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he went on to the highest heavens. Allahumma ij'al hubbaka habba ilayna min anfusina wa ahlina wa min al-ma'il barid. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم اجعل حبك أحب الأشياء إلينا واجعل خشيتك أقوف الأشياء عندنا واقطع عنا حاجات الدنيا بالشوق إلى لقائك وإذا أقررت أعين أهل الدنيا من دنياهم فأقرر أعيننا من عبادتك أبو بكر Ibn al-Habib alayhi rahma, Ibn al-Jawzi, the famous, well-known scholar, Allama, Ibn al-Jawzi alayhi rahma says, at the time of my teacher, my ustad, Abu Bakr, Ibn al-Habib's death, his students asked him, Ibn al-Jawzi is relating about the last moments of his ustad. At the time of my teacher, Abu Bakr, Ibn al-Habib's death, alayhi rahma, his talaba, his shagird, his students asked him, impart to us some advice. You have been teaching us your whole life. You are about to go. Impart to us some nasiha. He said, I advise you of three matters. I advise you of three matters. One, ittaqullah, taqwa. Fear Allah. Fear Allah. Two, remember him in seclusion. Udhkurullah fil qalwa. Remember Allah in seclusion, in privacy. Three, fear that thing which I am undergoing, that is death. I have lived for 61 years, yet they have passed by so quickly, that today it feels as though I have not even seen the world. This was his nasiha. May Allah help us remember his nasiha. I advise you, the teacher of Ibn al-Jawzi is telling his students, in three matters. One, ittaqullah, fear Allah. Taqwa, without taqwa, a person goes nowhere. Without the fear of Allah, that's the root of all virtues. Ittaqullah. Number two, Remember him in seclusion. Uzkurullah fil khalwa. Person can remember Allah in a gathering, that's good. In the masjid, amongst people, good. But when one is alone, alone, no one else, in privacy, in seclusion, remember Allah. And three, fear that thing. Fear that thing which I am undergoing, which is death. And we all have the taste of it, whether we like it, whether we don't like it, whether we are ready for it now or we are not ready for it. He says, fear that thing which I am undergoing, that is maut. I have lived for 61 years. Imagine he was a little baby, a 1 month old, 2 month old, 3 month old baby. I have lived for 61 years, yet they have passed by so quickly that today it feels as though I have not even seen the world. Ibn al-Jawzi alayhi rahmah said, he then asked someone sitting beside him, he said, look, is there perspiration on my forehead? And then the person confirmed, yes, it has appeared. The perspiration on your forehead has appeared. And he said, Alhamdulillah, thanks be to Allah, as it is a sign of dying on Iman, as stated in the hadith. Wow. He said, Alhamdulillah, perspiration on the forehead. It's there, Alhamdulillah. He asked someone sitting beside him, he said, look and see, is there perspiration on my forehead? He confirmed, yes, it has appeared. The teacher of Ibn al-Jawzi says, Alhamdulillah, as it is a sign, this is an alamat, a sign of dying on faith, dying on Iman, as stated in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. May that also appear on our foreheads, for that's a sign of dying upon Iman, as stated in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He then passed away, 61 years of the life of the teacher of Ibn al-Jawzi alayhi rahma. Rabi Ibn al-Kuthaym rahimahullah, addressing Rabi Ibn al-Kuthaym, Sayyiduna Abdullah Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, addressing whom? Addressing Rabi Ibn al-Kuthaym, Sayyiduna Abdullah Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, لو رآك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأحبك. What a praise. He wasn't from the Sahaba, he was from the Tabi'in. But Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu would address him. His name was Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym. Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym. He would address him and say, لو رآك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأحبك. Had the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seen you, he would have indeed loved you. What ta'rif. لو رآك النبي sallallahu alayhi wa sallam لأحبك. Had the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seen you, he would have loved you. What about us? Had the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seen us, would he have loved us? Or would he have been angry with us? He passed away in 64 Hijri. Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym, subhanallah, his practice was to remain awake all night. He just could not sleep. That was his practice, to remain awake all night. His student narrates, he was walking with Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu on the bank of the river Furat, on the bank of the river Furat, the bank of the Euphrates. Incident is in Iraq. When he came across a big furnace burning with fire, On seeing it, his body trembled, and he recited the following verses. Again, Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym rahimahullah's practice was to remain awake all night. His shagir, his student, tells us about him. He narrates that my ustad, Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym rahimahullah, was walking with that sahabi of the Prophet, the Grand Mufti of the Sahaba, with Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu on the bank of the river Furat, the Euphrates, when he came across a big furnace burning with fire. That had a great impact on him, that fire. On seeing it, his body trembled, and he recited the following verses. إِذَا رَأَتْهُم مِّن مَّكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِيُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّذًا وَزَفِيرًا. When we see fire, we should be remembered of that great fire, the fire of Jahannam. Allahumma jirna mina nar, because Allah has made fire as a reminder. Ja'alnaha tadhkira, ja'alnaha tadhkiratan wa mata'an lil muqween. He's seen this fire burning in the furnace, his body is trembling, and he's reciting the following verses come to his mind, and he recites it, that when Jahannam will see them from afar, إِذَا رَأَتْهُمْ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ, when Jahannam will see them from afar, سَمِيُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّذًا وَزَفِيرًا, They will hear tagayyud, that is the vehemence, anger, fury. They shall hear its vehement raging, tagayyud, wazafira, and that sound, that roaring sound, that frightening, abominable sound. Idha ra'athum, imagine that. They have not even entered Jahannam as yet. But Jahannam is seeing them from a distance. From a distance, Jahannam is seeing the inmates of Jahannam. إِذَا رَأَتْهُمْ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ, when Jahannam will see them مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ, from a distant place, far off, then they will hear سَمِيُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّذًا, they will hear تَغَيُّذ for it. They will hear a vehement raging, its fury, its anger, its vehemence, was zafira, and its roaring. He recited, wa idha ulqu minha makanan dayika mukarranin da'aw hunalika thubura. And when they are flung, wa idha ulqu minha ayyane fiha, when they are flung minha makanan dayikan mukarranin, linked all together in a tight space within. When they are all flung, linked all together into a tight space within, idha ulku minha makanan dayikan mukarranin, then they will call out, da'aw hunalika thubura, they will call out there with the cry of thubur, destruction. They will pray for destruction. They will pray for extinction. Extinction there and then. He recited these two verses, on seeing the fire in the furnace, where his mind goes. It shows his connection, his nisbat, his taqwa. Body is trembling, reciting the verses of the Quran. إِذَا رَأَتْهُمْ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِيُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّذًا وَزَفِيرًا إِذَا أُلْقُوا مِنْهَا مَكَانًا ضَيِّقًا مُكَرَّنِينَ, when they are flung, مُكَرَّنِينَ, how? Linked all together. Flung where? ضَيِّقًا, مَكَانًا ضَيِّقًا, flung into a tight space within. not wasi, but dayiq. Da'aw hunalika thubura, they will pray for extinction there and then. He recited these verses before lapsing into unconsciousness, his student says. He recited these verses before lapsing into unconsciousness, and his student said, we thus took him home. He recited these verses. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. He recited these verses before lapsing into unconsciousness, and we thus took him home. He lay in wait. He lay in wait for death. From that day, he lay in wait for death from that day onwards, and he made preparations for it. Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym, Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym, rahimahullah, was asked during his final illness, maradul maut, shall we not call the doctor for you? Shall we not call the doctor for you? After remaining silent for a few moments, he said, where is the community of Thamud? Where is the qawm? Aina qawmu Thamud? Aina qawmu Ad? Where is the people and community of Ad? Aina qawmu Ras? Where are the people of Ras? And the numerous communities that came in between, Allah had put before them all examples. He warned in various ways, but they believed not. Allah destroyed them all in the end, despite being present among them, those who could cure people and doctors. Allah destroyed them all in the end, despite being present amongst them, those who could cure people and doctors. They were not spared from destruction, and each one of them was annihilated. He went on to say, Wallah, by Allah, I will not call for a doctor for my treatment. His daughter, Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym, his daughter began to weep as he was about to pass away. Her father is about to die. A man whom Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu anhu would say, لَوْ رَآكَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَأَحَبَّكْ. Had the Prophet alayhi salam seen you, he would have indeed loved you. His daughter began to weep as he was about to pass away. So he said, O daughter, ya bint, do not weep, but say, today is a day of great joy. Today is a day of great joy, as my father has received a lot. Remember after the incident with the furnace and the fire, coming home, from that day on, he waited for death. Don't weep, but say, today is a day of great joy, as my father has received a lot. This is the meaning when the Prophet ﷺ would pray that, oh Allah, make our last day the best day in our lives. We have many days in our lives. We have Eid, we have Jummah, we have nice, happy occasions. But the Prophet ﷺ would pray that, oh Allah, that day in which you will take us from this world, make that day the best day of our lives. So, oh daughter, don't weep, but say, today is a day of great joy, as my father has received a lot. One narration has it that he addressed his daughter as she wept at the time of his death. He said, قَدْ أَقْبَلَ عَلَىٰ أَبِيكَ الْخَيْرِ. O daughter, weep not. قَدْ أَقْبَلَ عَلَىٰ أَبِيكَ الْخَيْرِ. Indeed, goodness has drawn near to your father. Goodness has advanced towards your father. قَدْ أَقْبَلَ عَلَىٰ أَبِيكَ الْخَيْرِ. As he said this, his ruh and his soul departed from his body. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. And this is Rabi ibn al-Kuthaym. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our death a blessed death also. Allahumma barik lana fil maut wa fima ba'da al maut. Allahumma inna nasaluka husna al-khatima. Allahumma inna nasaluka husna al-khatima. Rabbana la tuzigh kulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Social expectation drowns us all inside. What you have should be what I want, 'cause what I have just ain't alright.